Hi everyone, so in this video we'll talk about CAR T cells based immunotherapy. So let's get started. So talking about a small intro about what is CAR T cells. So these CAR T cells or chimeric antigen receptor are also known as artificial T cell receptors. Also these are genetically modified fusion molecules that can reprogram the specificity of polyclonal T cells against a selected cell surface target. So thereby they can modify a particular T cell to their use. And I also show how the CAR T cells are formed and their particular usage in the immunotherapy. So talking about a small brief history about CAR T cells, which all started in 1987 with through the creation of first chimeric antigen receptors by Zelikashar. Thereby 23 years later, the first successful treatment of cancer was done. And thereby 7 years later in 2017, Kymera introduced us to the CAR T cells. So with that, talking about the design of chimeric antigen receptor. So this particular receptor consists of pretty much the same domains as any receptor, which is the ectodomain, which is the head, you can say. And we have the transmembrane, which is the middlemost part of a receptor. And then we have the tail or the ectodomain. So this is the overall structure of a chimeric antigen receptor. So talking deep about this receptor would consist of an antigen recognition domain. So this particular ectodomain consists of the antigen recognition domain. Then we have the hinge or the spacer. So this is the hinge and the spacer you can see above the transmembrane. And then we have the transmembrane element. And lastly, we have a signal end domain. So this is the intracytoplasmic or the signaling end domain, or we can say the endodomain. So this is the overall design of a chimeric antigen receptor. So with that, talking about some of the difference between some of the parts of its design. So talking about the antigen recognition domain or the uppermost part or the ectoderm and the hinge and the spacer. So how these two terms are differentiated or how these two are different. So the antigen recognition domain determines the target specificity. Also, it co-expresses both antibody variable heavy and light chain into two separate polypeptide chains, thereby creating a single chain variable. Also, whereas a hinger or a space, what it does is it directly influences the antigen binding efficiency of CAR in redirected effector functions. So what it does, hinger, is it acts as a connecting bridge between the transmembrane and the endodomain. Also, whereas the antigen domain, what it does, it recognizes different antibodies and determines its target specificity. Different antibodies, I mean that it determines various heavy and the light chains into two different polypeptide chains. So it recognizes two different heavy and light chains into two different polypeptide chains, and thereby it induces its function. So moving with some more differentiations, we have the transmembrane element and we have the signaling endodomain. So how these two are different. So talking about the transmembrane element, so it serves as a fulcrum for transducing ligand recognition signal to the intracellular cytoplasmic domain. So it is more or less the same as a spacer or a hinge. So it acts as a fulcrum or a bridge for connecting the recognition signal or the endodomain to the ectodomain. And talking about the last part or the tail, so it consists of the T cell activating domain derived from TCR or CD3 complex. So it consists of the T cell activating domain. Alright, so moving with that. So talking about the purpose of CAR T cell development. So this is the escape of tumor surveillance mechanism. So these are the three main functions, which is the low immunogenicity, antigenic modulation and induction of lymphocyte apoptosis. So this is the purpose of CAR T cell development and why we need it. So this is the function that it satisfies, which is the low immunogenicity and antigen modulation and induction of lymphocyte apoptosis. So moving on, we'll see how this particular CAR T cells are engineered and how CAR T cells are made. So talking about its deep history or the mechanism how it's made. So you can see an antibody here, so which consists of the both heavy and light chains, and we have the T cell receptor here, which consists of various kinins and other domains. So you can see alpha, beta, gamma chains. You can see CD3 here, which consists of the T cell receptors. So when both antibody and T cell receptors are joined, it forms a chimeric antigen receptor, or you can say a CAR T cell. So when both the antigen, which consists of heavy and light chains, so you can see which joins to the alpha and beta chains of T cell receptors, it forms something like this. Alright, so this particular SCFV, which is a heavy chain which is attached to the head of the receptor, and you can see thereby it forms a transmembrane, and thereby we have the T cell receptor at the bottom or the tail or the ectodomain. So this is the overall structure of a CAR T cell, and this is how it's formed. It's just the amalgamation of antibody into T cell receptor. So you can see here CAR, it's also denoted as specificity of antigen antibody target recognition plus effector mechanism of T cells. So it's the amalgamation of the antibody or the specificity of antibody target recognition as well as the T cell receptors. So moving with that, so talking about how it reproduces, you can see here. So the first generation, second generation, third generation, it's very simple. So as it goes through different generations, it multiplies and forms more and more of its kind. So you can see ligands here, you can also see antigen binding domain, which is the topmost part, which is the antigen domain. Then we have the intracellular activation domain, and thereby we have the co-stimulatory domain as well. So thereby, as it goes through different generations, moves forward through the cycle, it forms more of its kind and gets better at cytotoxicity, proliferation and persistence. So it over the generation, its function increases, its effectiveness increases. So talking about the process, how CAR T cell immunotherapy is conducted. So you can see here, it's a very good diagram that is shown here for you. So let's say this starts off with a patient. You can see this is a very healthy normal patient. So it all starts with extraction of WBCs or white blood cells, including T cells. So it would start off by extracting T cells from the WBCs, which we known as leukapheresis. Alright, so after we extracted T cells from WBCs, what we'll do is we'll engineer those T cells. Alright, so we'll engineer those T cells by a gene encoding a chimeric antigen receptor is transferred into patient's T cells. So by engineering T cells, I mean that a gene is encoded which contains the chimeric antigen receptor is transferred into the patient's T cells. So there occurs a transfusion or transferring of chimeric antigen receptor cells into the patient's T cells, and thereafter expansion of CAR T cells is done, and thereby chemotherapy and then infusion of CAR T cells back into the patient's body is done. So this is how the CAR T cells administers its process via in a patient. So let's just keep this video till here. Hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.